Scientists created the first artificial elements during World War II, and they were actually classified at first. And it was only afterward that they were allowed to announce the discovery of these new elements. When you're creating a new element, the basic idea is that you have a target of something, and you have a beam of something else, and you shoot the beam at the target. Every so often, one of the beam atoms will knock into one of the target atoms, and the two nuclei will fuse together, and you'll get a heavy element after that fusion occurs. So when you're deciding what atom to shoot at another atom, in one sense, it's very easy. It's just arithmetic. So if you have element 100 and you shoot element 12 at it, the resulting atom will be an atom of element 112. The difficulty comes in that some combinations of atoms, depending on different properties, are very unlikely to fuse. If you pick the wrong elements, basically, for your target and your beam, it's very unlikely that anything will happen. So it's very, very difficult to tell when they have actually created an atom of these new elements. And for the most part, nowadays, they are discovering this fact retroactively. So only after the element has already decayed radioactively into something else. When scientists are making these elements, usually three or so is the rule for the number they need to really count. In some cases, it has taken scientists up to 9 years of work, doing it not every single day, but doing it for months at a time. Right now, scientists think that there could be two reasons the periodic table could stop. First of all, there's a very prevalent theory that says that right around element 172, some weird kind of spooky quantum mechanical things might happen, where you're having electron-positron pairs formed, and the nucleus itself might start gobbling up electrons and destroying them, turning them into neutrons. But there's a lot of scientists that think that well before the point of 172, that the nucleus will be so unstable that it will basically disintegrate almost instantly. Around element 120, it's going to be particularly challenging to make new elements for a couple of reasons. The first and primary reason right now is getting enough target atoms in order to actually produce them. And right now, we just don't have the technology to mass produce enough of the target atoms. After 120, the lifetimes of these elements also keeps dropping even more. So even if you produce one, it gets harder and harder to detect them at this point. So the island of stability comes in because there's a theory out there that says if you have a certain magic number, as they call it, of protons and neutrons, those nuclei will be especially stable. And it's possible we could see exotic and interesting traits like that emerge as we start to get closer and closer to the island of stability. One example of a new and kind of exotic property emerging unexpectedly is the element mercury. So at room temperature, mercury is actually a liquid, which is unlike the other elements in its column. And because mercury is a liquid at room temperature, it has a lot of really useful properties. You can use it in things like thermometers and barometers. So a lot of early science depended on this trait of mercury. We have created every element up to 118. So we have a nice complete periodic table up to the seventh row. The next new element that scientists create will either be element 119 or 120. So that'll have to go on an eighth row, kind of by itself, hanging out there. Right now, scientists are content putting these new elements in the spot they should go on the periodic table, just based on what their atomic number is, so based on the number of protons that they have. But we've already seen in a couple of cases a few elements that deviate a little bit, both chemically and physically, their chemical and physical properties, from what they should be. So as we move down into much heavier atomic numbers, we'll probably see more and more of these anomalies. And then it will be an actual debate. Do we put them where they should go, or put them more where their properties say they should go? So scientists do think there are some good practical reasons for trying to find these new elements. One is that the technologies that they're developing to create these new elements, basically the particle accelerators, the separators, the detectors, things like that, can be used in other applications. Another application is things like radioisotopes for medicine. A lot of the accelerators and technologies that are used to make those nowadays were pioneered looking for new elements. I think it's just human nature to want to keep pushing, to keep going. And the periodic table does have this really iconic place in science where it's something we all learn about, we all remember it from chemistry class, even if it's the only thing we remember. I would bet scientists are never going to stop making and trying to make new elements on the periodic table.